All right, what we're trying to do is make archery fun again. We do this, we call it our Bow Hunter Shakedown. We're setting our 3D targets up. We're not quartering them real hard like PHE and Deermans and stuff like that. But every one of my setups was a challenge, and all these hunters realized that after they came here. Walking song. It really separates the hunters from the target shooters. We love the target shooters. We're a great, big, huge archery family. For one reason or another, our family is getting smaller and smaller. So me and Carrie decided, well, you know, we want to do something different. So we did. Sing and then swing low. And with the help of our friend George at 3D Country and knowing art through the years repairing targets, we decided, we got trained to fix our own targets, to paint them, and we're kind of painting them our way. Painting them the way that the animals really look. We have real-life hunting scenarios out here. We're offering things for emergency needs if somebody's bow breaks or, you know, this time of year, a lot of these guys are pulling their bows out for the first time since last year. Things happen when they come out on the shoot. We are totally set up and ready to fix it. So with the help of Davenport Archery, several other people, I can't even start to mention. Have really developed something good, I think, here. We have people camping. We have a great time here. Everybody just has fun. There's no whining, there's no crying. I really hope that this kind of catches on. Unfortunately, I think next year we're not going to have any qualifiers at all. We're kind of going to get away from the target scene. We're still going to shoot it. We love them. They're our family. But I think we're going to focus more on the fun type shooting. Get people laughing. Nobody laughs anymore. So we take it too serious.
What's different about your scoring system on this shoot than versus the ASA scoring, and why do you do that?
Our scoring system is based on a hunting type scenario. We use a 10, we use the 8, but then if you hit anywhere outside that 8 is a minus 5. We do that in a reality type deal where the odds of you finding your deer hit anywhere else is at a lower percentage than if you hit it in the 10 and the 8. The minus 5, you don't get rewarded for hitting it in any other part except for a kill zone. But there again, that's why I don't quarter them either, because that's changing the shot angle. So we don't do the 12s in play or anything like that. As you noticed on the novelty shoots though, our tree stand, every score ring is in play, but it's still minus 5 if you hit outside of it. So it's just something that we didn't develop it. It's just we're bringing it back. This is the way it used to be, and it's changed for one reason or another. So we're gonna try to change it back. So we had a good turnout today. I expect a way better one tomorrow. And this is how it should be. The last few archery shoots I went to has been a very low turnout. what we're doing here is we are changing up the way that 3D shooting is a little bit and what it used to be. And Ladybug, do you care to say something else while we're talking? Okay, but I think the interview is for me. Yeah, just lay there and be quiet. Thank you. Okay, take two.
She's going to do it again.
Ladybug, come on.
That's awesome.
She wants to be on TV.
Ladybug.
Hey. All right, well, tell them what we're doing here. Go ahead, tell them. It's okay. He's not going to hurt Daddy.
Okay.
Take two.
All right.
Quick.
Sorry, buddy. He's got his finger.
D Nice.
Alicia, ask where Dave is D Nice? Your name. Alicia, ask Dave how to spell your name.
She's not over here right now.
Oh.
Is there a Jaquillin? Jaquillin.
Oh, that's gonna look cool.
There you go, Jim.
Oh.
No.
Come on, girl.
There you go. There you go.
There you go.